Car sales went up by 23.2% in February, according to data from the Chamber of Automotive Manufacturers of the Philippines and the Truck Manufacturers Association. Sales rose to 38,000 units last month. That's up from 30,900 in February last year. Sales of passenger cars went up by 34%, while commercial vehicle sales grew by 19.8%. Campi attributes these figures to marketing campaigns and improved inventories, supported by stable interest rates that continue to boost customer confidence. Our correspondent Jackie Pascual now joins us with the latest, this time from Manila's main gateway, the Ninoy Aquino International Airport. Jackie, how is it there?
Hi, good afternoon, Denise. Passengers continue to arrive here at the Ninoy Aquino International Airport. Today is the expected peak of the travel season, Wednesday, with more people flying to the provinces or abroad for the Holy Week break. Manila International Airport Authority General Manager Eric Ines said that they are prepared for the possible increase in the number of passengers, which is expected to go higher by late afternoon or this evening, since some people work this morning. Ines also advises passengers to allot more time going to the airport, especially since there may be traffic in roads leading to the terminals. He also apologizes if the temperature inside the airport, particularly at NAIA Terminal 2, may be hot. They are fixing the air conditioning system, admitting too that they need more air conditioning units. An issue, hopefully, he said, will be resolved by the incoming private consortium who will operate NAIA later this year. Ines also clarified a report that there was a power outage at NAIA 2, and he said it wasn't a power outage, but there was an issue affecting the aircon system. But he assures passengers that all basic services at NAIA are running smoothly. The Civil Aviation Authority of the Philippines, meanwhile, assures the public that the CAAP Communications Navigation and Surveillance Air Traffic Management System is working well, and the January 1, 2023 incident, which closed down the Philippine airspace, will not happen again. Denise, around 140,000 to 150,000 passengers are expected at NAIA today, and the MIAA says that hopefully there won't be any flight interruptions or delays. Yesterday, the on-time performance rate at NAIA is around 86%, which the MIAA says is higher than international standards. And that's the latest at NAIA. Back to you, Denise.
Thanks for that, Jackie.
The negotiations on a Gaza ceasefire deal still ongoing. This assurance coming from Qatar, who mediated in the Gaza conflict. The Qatari Foreign Ministry, however, admitted it cannot offer any timeline on an agreement, but it vowed to continue to cooperate with regional and international partners to push forward the talks. The war in Gaza has claimed the lives of over 32,000 Palestinians and injured 74,000 more.
The talks are ongoing, the efforts are ongoing, and that in its own right is a good thing, certainly. As I said, I don't have any update over the timelines or how we can gauge optimism over the current situation, but we remain hopeful.
An update now on the Holy Week exodus here in the Philippines. Transport officials expect the number of Lenten travelers to reach its peak today, Holy Wednesday. Thousands have flocked to the Parañaque Integrated Terminal Exchange, a transport hub servicing people headed out of Metro Manila. Security has been tightened at the PITX. Officials expect the mad dash of the provinces to continue until Monday, Thursday.